Good morning. Continuing the Maimon of Vaykach Korach. Well, we are holding by the page 28, Chaf Ches and the Dvamachus. Continue with Hey. The last discussion that we had about the statement of the Mishnah that what is Machlekes Hashem Shomayim, an argument that is for the sake of heaven. That's the debates of Vesham and Vesil. And when in time of Mashiach, somehow the opinion of Vesham and Vesil are both going to come true, meaning that the halacha will be like both of them. How it's going to work out, we are learning now. What type of a debate is for the sake of heaven? The debate of Hillel and Shammai. Ki klolu sachibu the shem Shomayim, kashmius veruchnius, physicality and spirituality, tachtoinim veluyonim, lower ones and upper ones. Naso the basifanim. Shehem beis akavin shebaim chalukim shamay vehil. Shezeu gam sher shamachlok shkoa tanim amiroi. Interestingly, he writes that the chibu, which means the connection between physicality and spirituality, between lower ones and upper ones, happens through the two, you could say, train of thought of Shammai and Hillel. And this is really the roots of all the machlokes between the Tannaim and the Amiraim. Lahachmir v'le'esor mitzad kav ha'gevur o lahakir la'atir from the side of chesed. Aynu she'ein ze koshu v'osiv d'achitzin. Kav ha'chesed. So he says really the root of all machlokes between Tannaim and between the Tannaim and the Amoraim is all boils down to Chesed or Gevura. So if your neshama is rooted in Chesed, you will always tilting for Chesed. If your neshama is rooted in Gevura, always be tilted to Gevura. Kamo b'l'kuter dibu ha-matchil keitzem rak nifne ha-kal. He's a maimer of the Alter Rebbe who speaks about Beishama Imrim Kalu Kimishu, we see the Lemrim Kalna Chasud, famous machlokes. The Gemara, I believe, is Ksuvis, Gemara Ksuvis design. So it says, what do you do if you go to a chasene and you see that the Kala is ugly? Mm-hmm. What do you do? So according to Bishamai, gotta say the truth.
I went to a wedding.
Gevura. Say it as it is. According to Vesilel, you need to say that she's beautiful. Kala no chasud. Why? Even if she has chasoidas, even if she has a lot of, a whole list of shortcomings, you have to say beautiful. Wonderful.
She's beautiful.
Yeah. So why is it? Why Rabbi Shammai is telling you to say you have to deviate from the truth? Even if you see trouble is coming, And according to Beit Shammai, you need to say that as he said as it is. He says, because Shoshim Bchinas HaGevuris. Again, Beit Shammai rooted in Midas HaDin, they are very stern, machmir, strict.
You
know what the meaning of the word Shammai in Hebrew? Shammai is an appraiser. And this is a connector with this. He says, when it comes to Shammai, Shammai is always evaluating your ways. Hashem Rechoysov. He's always evaluating. What is it? How is it? And what he sees is what he says. And it comes, it expresses itself in Avodas Hashem, the way he serves Hashem. Which means, whatever you give, you say, like the saying, it comes around, goes around, whatever you do, that's what you get. You daven this way, you keep Shabbos this way, you did tzedakah that way. It's according to the measure that you elevated, that's what you're getting back. Okay? You prepare the package, and you are going to receive similarly from above. That's Beit Shammai. Ava b'sila, v'sila sheresh b'b'china sachasodim. Rooted in chesed. Disagreed with Beit Shammai. And he says, Shileiti am shochel lefialo. He says, am shochel should not be like the drawdown should not be like the elevation. El adarav, tchiloti am shochel lemailo lemato. Al kei nikrail am lo shbilunir. He says, no, Beisila is chesed. First of all, I'm giving you Amshocha without you doing anything. I'm giving you. It's a drawdown that comes to you without you doing anything. Then you're doing something, you're going to get even above and beyond of what you did. Which means they turned, they lit a candle. Lit a candle on my head. They lit a candle. My head, Shuinyana, Eir, Vagilu, and Milo Dark, representing light that comes from above. The Kol Echad Mitzrayim, for every single Jew. And according to Hillel, Afilu Chigeres, even if the color is limping, Chas V'Sholom, Afilu Sumav, even if she's blind, you need to say, Kalo Nova Chasuda. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful catch.
I was wedding like this. I had to be the father for this guy, he converted in this way. So before the wedding, she's like all hysterical, and she's heavy. And I said, oh my God, what's going to be? Actually, it ended up, he's all right. He got four kids with her, they're doing okay.
So oh, Hashem, you see?
Ruch Hashem, so he has, the guy is such a chesed guy, you don't know. He's a very chesed guy. He can take a lot.
So that's where how they get to it. Meaning that's how Beit Shammai get to what to the conclusion that they get to, and they still get to the conclusion that they got to because of their source in Chesed.
Rabbi Gerari's son goes to the yeshiva with his son in Cincinnati.
Yeah, now if you look at line 2, it says any machlekes for the sake of heaven is a machlekes of Shammai and Hillel. Why? Ki chibur olam elikus, the bond of the world with godliness, Shem Shomayim, shezoi tachlisa shel machlekes Shem Shomayim. That's the purpose of machlekes, for the sake of heaven. Nasa the base hakavin dalo melamato lemailo. I'm sure melamailo lemato. Now the Rebbe says something interesting. He tells you that the Shammai represents elevation, the work that you do in this world, And Beis Hillel represents the drawdown, the Amshocha. So why specifically they chose the Machlokes of Bisham and Beis Hillel? You could have said, what is the Machlokes of Shem Shemayim? The Machlokes of Abaye and Rava. Rabba and Rava. There's so many examples of Lashem Shemayim.
Famous one, though, you know, everybody.
Because connecting the world with godliness, Shemayim, connecting the heavens
yeah.
with the earth. That's the purpose of the Machlokes. What is the Machlokes of Lashem Shemayim? What are you trying to accomplish? You're trying to accomplish the chibur between heaven and earth. Why are you trying to get to the truth? You get to the bottom of it. You're trying to get to the halacha, to know the right halacha, to make sure the right ruling and the psak is correct. Why is it so important? Because you're trying to create a bond between heaven and earth.
Yeah.
And so, how can you create the bond? Through Beis Shammai and Beis Hillel together.
But again, your argument comes stronger because the other ones are doing the same thing too.
What do you mean?
You know, you said about like Rava and Shmuel and they're all doing this. They're not like
right, but it was primarily done between Beis Shammai and Beis Hillel. Why? Because Beis Shammai was the ultimate Gevurah,
right?
And Beis Hillel by them. The Gevurah and Chesed was so dominating, each one, so it was emphasized by them. That's what the Rebbe is trying to ask. He asked the question because he said, why can't you say that other machlokes are also Lashem Shemayim? We know for sure that other machlokes is.
Right. I mean, you know, Rabbi.
Because it doesn't say the only machlokes that was Lashem Shemayim was machlokes of Shammai and Hillel. He says, called machlekes, that it's an example of why they use them as an example. So he tells you because they represent the ultimate bond between heaven and earth. The Shammai is the elevation from below, and the Hillel represents the Amshocha, the drawdown. And he continues to explain it. V'aderech klolus achiluk sheben Moshe v'Aaron, like the difference between Moshe and Aaron. What's the difference between the two? Shemesh and medakdek b'chol dovor im al piter. Moshe looked at everything, was very scrupulous, if it's according to Torah or not according to Torah.
Right.
By the letter of the law, it's not by the letter of the law. Adech Hashom, Hashom or Chosov, like Shammai. Evaluating.
Right.
Elevation. Ve'aroin, oyoiv, sholoim. Over Sabrius, Aaron was a leave. It was a peace seeker and loved peace, loved the Brias.
Yeah.
And Shiloh and Ksiv Avkus, a silent call basis. So it says that when Aaron passed away, men and women cried for him.
Mm-hmm.
Moshe passed away, only the men cried for him. It says by Aaron called Beis Yisrael. Why? Because he pursued peace. He made peace between husband and wives. And Shuinyan Amshocha v'agilim l'may l'mat. So Aaron represents the Amshocha, the drawdown. Uloy gam shemei shinyon teiro shivayf shal Amshocha v'lamay lo. Shivayf shal Amshocha v'lamay l'mat. He says, but one second, Moshe Rabbeinu is also Amshocha because it's Torah. Moshe is a holy union, is Torah, and Torah is Amshocha. And Aaron is the concept of davening, which is the elevation. So we see that they both have both qualities. So in time of Mashiach, we'll have the two ways of avodas Hashem. The bond between the upper and the lower, spirituality and physicality, the love amshocha gam yachad, elevation and drawdown together. This is a Maimer of the Alter Rebbe, Pirush Maimer of Sinu Zal, explaining a statement in the Gemara of Batra 75, Pligei, what is the prophecy of the time of Mashiach, Vesamti Kadked Shimshi Saich. Chadoma, one said, it's speaking about a precious stone, Shoyam. The name of the stone would be Shoyam. Chadoma Yoshpe. The name of the stone is not Shoyam, it's rather Yoshpe. Okay? So Hashem said, you know what? I'll have the stone both ways, Shoyam and Yoshpe together. And that's what it tells you, the time of Mashiach, you'll have the two levels. The elevations of the world will take place from below, from us. We are elevating. That we will bring the lower one. We will ascend the lower one. The lower one will ascend on high. And they're going to have also revelation from above. And there is an advantage to each one, to the initiation from below and to the drawdown that is initiated from above. Meaning each one on its own. If we initiate, if Hashem is causing us to be aroused and to do things, it's not completely our work. So there's uniqueness and superiority to if we do something on our own.
Yeah, but we don't even know if we're doing something on our own.
And right, but Hashem can give you a little spark. Always, have to have the little spark. But the question is, how much does it's really you? That's one of the Avodah of Moshe Rabbeinu, that he was trying to work with the Jews to be pnimi, to be an inner Jew, which means that if I takes away the clouds from them, and all the things that they're surrounded, they'll still be living in Hashem.
Right.
Still understand that there's a likus in the world. Because he knew they're not always going to have it.
Right.
So it says right now it's you're living in a cocoon. What's going to happen if you don't have the clouds? You don't have this, you don't have that.
We had a bumpy road for a while.
But the point is that each one, it's being done on its own. Elevations of the world will take place from below, that the lower one will ascend on high. There will be also revelation from above down. In 27, there's a superiority to each one, or advantage to each one. Amayla de'aleis ha'tachton, what is the advantage of the tachton ascending on high? Isha l'dei ha'zikuch sheloi, through his refinement, when the lower one is ascending on high, it's through his refinement, through his purification. Neisav l'kach shesh b'ze gam ha'ilu yishiroi tzad m'kav shel, beside the advantage that each one is proud, each person is proud in his accomplishment, more than the accomplishment of his friends, even though his friends' accomplishment can be 10 times more, but he's still interested in doesn't want his friend because he worked on this. He was able to get that far. Harei umisached im ha'er v'pnimius yesa. He's going to accomplish a greater unity. Mashen can be rida sa'el yoyin. So meaning after the refinement, after the work that he did with himself, he becomes now a vessel for a godly light to shine in him innerly. Mashen can be rida sa'el milamato. But when you get a gift from above, not necessarily that your kli is prepared for it. Kevan sha'kli lein izdakich, your kli is not refined, was not purified. In although there is a godly revelation that comes into him, supernal light is now coming down. The revelation is not united with the kli. It's not called kach, meaning there is some kind of unity. The light is not going to come for nothing. But there's a godly revelation that comes down, but the unity is not really there. So that's the advantage of the tachta in the refining the kli, working with yourself. And now when there is a revelation, it goes, it penetrates you, it permeates you, becomes one with you. And what is the advantage of the Elyon in the upper one coming down? By itself, because the revelation has come from a higher place. Remember we said, whatever you are elevating, that's what comes down. That's when you're initiating something. But when it's come from above, when Hashem is bringing down, He doesn't bring it according to what you did. So that's the greatness of it. It says, Sham Shochaso, Mokin Gavaris, it comes from a higher place. Shalochin Bekoch Lovul is Gaus Lamata Yisra. That's why, if it comes from a higher source, it can reveal itself in lower places. It's not for the sake of heaven. What is it? The Machlok is of Korach, V'chol Adosei. Korach and his community. V'chol Adosei, V'ainu. Korach v'adosei, Otsu b'chibur shel Shem. Metzius hayesh, im shomayim, elikus, elarotsu, shisher, ashdov, onifu. Shlochin kohan shishem. It says that Korach and his assembly did not want the chibur, did not want to create a bond of the yesh, the physical, with shomayim, with the heavens. Shem is the yesh, and shomayim is the spirituality, the heavens. They didn't want to create that bond. Ela rotsu, what did they want? Shishoyra yesh davoni, for they wanted to leave the yesh as something separated. The physical to be separated. Shaloch anikru anshi shem. And that's why they were given the name anshi shem. Val zeh. Omro b'sim zal. Ein shem el aved azo. The rabbi said, what is shem? Like we see, going back to the generation of the disbursement, they wanted them to build a name, make a name. So what is the name? Is aved azo. Some people till today they have thing with branding. They have to have a specific brand. They bow to the brand. They have to wear it. They have to buy it. They, no matter how much it costs, they're.
Yeah, like Gucci or something.
They know with Zal. So shebechutzlo is David Zohar b'Torah. It's a statement in a tractate of David Zohar. Chesam Udalef 8a. It says over there that all Jews that are living outside of Eretz Yisrael, they are oivde avodah zarah, serving idols or doing avodah zarah, but they are, because that they live in outside of Eretz Yisrael, they are considered as oivde avodah zarah betayro, which means bedakus, in a very subtle way, there is something has to do with avodah zarah, living outside of Eretz Yisrael. This is not Chassidus telling it to you. This is the Gemara in avodah zarah ches amud aleph. V'tam adovo, what is the reason? Ki b'chutz la'oretz gozul tuma al aviro v'gusha. Chutz la'oretz, outside of Eretz Yisrael, the rabbis decreed impurity on the air and the clumps of earth. Lefi sheshom, because outside of Eretz Yisrael, nimshach ha-shefa l'ki al de levushim rabim. Godly flow goes outside of Eretz Yisrael through many garments. Va'ad l'islav shu b'levush ha-tev, until it encloses itself in a physical garment. So much so that the godly light is enclosed so much that you don't see that Hashem is the one that runs the show. Beven Shodom Yochel Lachshi Vesaz is as good as Parnasa Tachbulo is Kilu Inyani Kobash Posse. It's like a person think about through his tricking, doing different tricks in his business.
He thinks he's so smart.
Doing, yeah, he's thinking this is why he's successful.
He's such a genius.
Yeah.
I don't realize today
it
could be up in the
market. It says, if you think by you figuring out something and doing this movement and this move and that move, that's what gives you the parnasa. He writes that you are like bowing to the moon and the sun. It's like seeing, oh, here's the moon. The moon is helping the crop to grow. As the pasuk says, that there is an influence from the sun and the moon for the growth. But he doesn't contemplate, he doesn't stop to think that all the moon and the sun are just shluchim, are just emissaries for the flow. Just like an axe in the hand of the woodchopper. Without the woodchopper, the axe could not do anything. The only way you are able to chop down the tree is because somebody is holding on to this axe and chopping. Imagine someone would come and praise the axe. Wow, what a wonderful axe.
It's an idiot.
Exactly. So what, the axe could not do anything. It's the person that holding the axe and chopping with it. And this similarly, when it comes to the mazolis, to the constellations, Rabbi said, any blades of grass has a mazel above that tells it to grow. The mazel is also kegazen v'adocha. It's also like the axe in the hand of the woodchopper. Mishakosa, page Lamed Aleph in line 1, because a Rambam shen roi lovdom. Rambam writes that the mazolis should not be, no one should serve the mazolis. Try to pray to them. Try to create the emissaries of Hashem to make them closer to you, on your side, so to speak. A person should direct his thought only to Hashem. And leave everything that is beside him, live alone. Like the famous Maimer, Ana Nosiv Malko, I choose the king, I go for the king, I go for nothing else. Rather, he says, when you give attention and you consider and you give importance to the middleman, the Mutzoyim is the middleman. The moon, the sun, the constellations, that the flows go through them, but you are considering them to an existence of their own, as if they have power of their own. It's, you're doing exactly the opposite. You are separating them from their source.
You know, some people have the same question about when they go to the Kibbutz Rakul or to the Machpelah or to the Kotel or to the Rebbe or whatever.
No, yeah, over there, asking the tzaddik to ask on your behalf, to ask whom? To ask Hashem. You're not praying to the tzaddik. You're asking the tzaddik to pray. You're praying to Hashem next to the tzaddik. And you're asking the tzaddik to pray for you on your behalf.
I'm just saying, people have this.
So what is machlekes that is not for the sake of heaven? Machlekes of Korach and his assembly. What is the machlekes of Korach? He wants to be a separate entity. It's not for the sake of heaven. What is Hashem Shomayim? Shem Shomayim is creating the bond, the connection between a godliness and physicality. The chibur is caused by kushus shalmei shavaron. We basically find him in the two ways: the milamayla lamata and milamata lamayla. the ways of Aaron, which we said is Amshacho, and the ways of Meshu, which is Allah, opposite. The ways of Meshu is elevation. Medaktik b'Torah, he's very scrupulous in every matter in Torah. If it's according to Torah, not according to Torah. Making sure the elevation is complete, is perfect. And Aaron is the Amshacho. But we said that both of them has both qualities.
And
why Korach didn't want it? Because he was from Gevurah. He was mainly from Gevurah. He was only from Gevurah. Moshe had also chesed in him. It was primarily Gevurah and had chesed. Aaron is primarily chesed and Gevurah. So they're able to combine the two. But on the other hand, Korach was only Gevurah. It says, he wanted to make sure that the separation remains between physicality and spirituality. That was the objective of Korach. Why? Because Shehoyu mebchinas hagvuris bilvad. Korach was from the tribe of Levi, and his assembly were all connected from Gevuris. Lo iskalsa chasodim, it's Gevuris without combining chasodim in them.
That's why it says, that it is not for the sake of heaven.
It's not going to endure. It's not that the Mishnah is trying to tell Korach, God forbid, something negative. Since there's a promise that eventually all Jews will do tshuva and no one will be distanced from godliness for good. So it's a must that Avdolo should not remain, separation should not remain. Eventually will be elevation of the Yesh. And it will be nullified, the existence will be nullified to its court, its source. The reason why Hashem created the separation to begin with is for the refinement of it, for the elevation of it. Which brings afterwards a much greater revelation. That even something that was seemingly opposing Kedusha becomes a vessel for godliness, so closing in tshuva. That's the whole idea of tshuva. Take something that was distant, far away, and bring it closer. That's why it says, on the third day, Tuesday, two times kitov, one for Monday and one for Tuesday. One for the separation that was done on Tuesday, the separation between the upper water and the lower water. That which is the root of all separation between created beings and all machlokes. And then you have on Tuesday of pamayim kitov, twice good. Because ultimately the separation brings elevation. That you would not come to that elevation without the separation. It says, even when we come to machloket of Korach, there's also tshuva in there. Even though they went to Sheol, they went to the depth, they went to the abyss, eventually they ascended. Because they created machlokes on kehuna, eventually kehuna became elevated even higher. It says the end of the parasha, Hashem says to Aaron, I gave you as mishmeres moroisai. It says in Talmud Yerushalmi in Maseches Haroyos about an incident with Rabbi Lezer, Rabbi Yishun, Rabbi Akiva, that they went to Antochia, a place for a collection. And there was Abba Yehuda, he would give tzedakah to. He gave tzedakah, and one time he lost his money, and he saw the rabbis.
and his face was looking dire. So it told him, why do you look that way? So he says, what should I do? He says, I don't know what to do. His wife, that was more righteous than him, said, you still have one field, go sell half the field and give it to the rabbis so that they have something to give them. So he went and he did it. So they davened for him. And they said, Hashem should give you all the things that you have lost. When they left, he went to a plow in the half the field that he had left. And as he was doing it, his cow, the leg of the, there was a little pit, and the leg of the cow broke. And he went down to the pit to help her to get out, and he found a whole treasure in there. So we see that seemingly something from the silver lining that we'll talk about. See, sometimes a seemingly something negative, but you see the positive, and then there is a treasure that is waiting. So this was really this machlokes was ended up benefiting Aaron, because it says, Hashem is now even emphasized more the importance of Aaron. It says like a king that gives his son a inheritance. He gives him a field, a house, and comes to somebody and he starts to question the validity of his ownership. Right?
Yeah.
So now, so the king said, now that somebody questioned it, I'm going to put it on, I'm going to engrave it on a stone that it's yours. So this child now is thankful for the guy that questioned it, because now
it's more official.
Now it's official. Says, so same thing over here. Korach comes and he questioned the whole kihuna, the whole priesthood. Hashem came down, gave him 24 gifts of kihuna.
Anyway,
welcome to you.